Hello and welcome, my beautiful, vibrant souls, who came here to listen to me trip over my chair. Oh boy. Hello, hello, welcome. Welcome back to all my old friends, and hello to all my new friends. Today's reading is going to be a quick little pick a card, a quick a card, if you will. And it's just going to be a yes or no answer to whatever question you have. We have five options to choose from today. You can answer up to five questions utilizing all of them. You know the drill with traditional yes or no's. So feel free to hold your question in your mind and meditate on the options in front of you. We have option one with the gold stone. I'm going to make sure I'm putting this in the frame so you can see. Option one with the gold stone. We have option two with the bloodstone. We have option three with the peacock or option four with the, this one, green calcite, there we go. If I wait long enough, she'll come back to me. Then we have option five with this amethyst. So take your time, meditate, contemplate on the stacks in front of you. Again, you can answer up to five different questions, utilizing one pile for each to get your yes or no. excuse me. Wow, you guys, sorry about that. If you are looking for a yes or no reading for a personal situation, please feel free to check out my shop link in the description box below. I do offer yes or no readings. But with that, I think that's everything I need to get into, and let's start with group one. Well, how do we do this? Okay. Hello, group one. So I had to move some of the other card stacks out of the way to make room. So you are attracted to this lovely gold stone. This to me usually says that good times are coming. There's just one little dark stripe in it. So this to me means like a challenge that needed to be overcome, or there's like one little like wrench in the works here is almost what I'm getting. Like one little twerp, but no, there's like one little like sticking point. So I feel like remain positive because there's still a lot of good energy around you right now. You have a lot of support as well. I don't know why I'm getting that, but I'm kind of getting that feeling like energetically and from your spiritual team and from people in your life. Excuse me. So this is a playing card from my yes or no deck. I utilize a playing card deck to be equivalent to the 52 cards of the minor arcana. And this is always the yes or no that I use in all my yes or no readings, which thank you to anyone who's purchased one with me. I love getting a read for all of y'all on any subject. So let's see what you got. Ooh, okay. You have the Four of Swords. So this isn't necessarily strictly a yes or no. Texas might be important to you, the letters T or X. We have the number seven reference here, and of course, four. Can you see that? Nice. Okay. Sorry, I'm really good at holding it out of the frame. So this isn't strictly a yes or no. I tend to lean a little more toward no, especially anything where there's like an action, right? So the Four of Swords is usually about rest, rejuvenation. If this is a question of communication, like should I reach out to them? Will they reach out to me? This is a no. Not right now at this time. And you know, granted, these are snapshots of the energy. So if you get an answer that you don't particularly love, just know that things can change. But right at this moment, excuse me. So, you know, if this is kind of like, if you're asking questions about like healing, and you know, I'm not a mental or physical health professional, so nothing we talk about should be considered substitution for professional diagnosis, treatment, or advice. But if this is questions of healing, questions of, you know, am I ever going to feel better about this? Are we ever going to like, you know, are we ever going to mend this relationship? Are we ever going to get over that argument? The answer is yes, but I feel not at this time. So let's get some more information. Okay, there it is. You have Lover. I like it. He looks very dapper. You have, oh yeah, you're the only group that got two of the advice cards. Okay, you got a leg up. So this to me always talks about spirit giving you a leg up. We're talking about a lot of support right now, like energetic support. This is a 34, so that reduces to a seven. Yeah, I'm deciding if I wanna flip these now. Hang on, I'll wait a sec. So this may very well have to do with love. This heart right here has got like the lines on one side, so it's darker. So this may be where one of you is ready to make up and the other one's not. This could be there needs to be a balance of light and shadow energies here. Again, there's like one little thing, one little wrench in the works here. So if you're waiting for somebody to come forward and express their love, or you're waiting for the right time to express your love, I do feel like the time to communicate is gonna come, and probably pretty soon. You know, swords are actually pretty fast moving energy, so the Four of Swords can talk about like maybe something that's about a month away roughly. But you know, we have all this winter imagery here. Things have been in a freeze, things have been in a holding pattern. And this doesn't have to mean no communication. This also can just mean like things aren't moving forward, but that's because there's healing here. I do feel like whoever this is in your life, they have some shadow stuff they're trying to heal. And it's like they're almost there. There's just a little bit left that needs to be done. And with a leg up, I feel like spirit is really supporting both of you in this time, right? For some of you, you want to heal from an old relationship, and you're saying, will I ever get over them? Yes, you will. I like that we have a seven there and a seven there. I just noticed that. So like the answer, you know, yes, you will get over it. You will heal from this. New love will come into your life and you will be able to welcome it into your life. And right now spirit's really trying to help you because you can't see it, but this little polar bear baby has like icicles hanging off its little paws. So you've been out there for a minute. You're cold. You're cold, baby. It's okay. And so right now spirit's really trying to help comfort you and say, now is the time to really believe in your own healing, is what I'm getting out of this, because there are better things up ahead. So let's see what your advice is. Wow, yeah, change in direction. Okay. The changes you're experiencing are divinely directed by your newborn willingness to open your heart to love and our guidance. Wow, same things here. You are protected now and in the future, so follow your path to the to the happy outcomes you desire. Oh my God, the words. And then you have, be honest with yourself. And she's got her arms crossed over her heart space. Look into your heart and you will know the truth of the situation. It's safe to admit the truth to yourself, for we will support and guide you through any necessary changes. Lean upon us for courage and the strength to take good care of yourself. Focus only upon your true desires and they'll come to you upon angel's wings. Yeah, so what I feel like is happening is that there's this situation going on where I do feel like it's overwhelmingly positive, right? Like there are happy changes taking place. Spirit's giving you a leg up, but I do feel like it might kind of be either slow moving, or it's kind of one of those things where it feels like it's got to get worse in order to get better. You might be going through some emotional healing and it's like, why is this happening now? And it's to help purge whatever wounding is there, whatever shadow energy is there, in order to welcome in love. For some of you, you experience the sudden cutoff or drop off of a relationship and you're like, what the hell, man? This is actually spirit helping you, because I feel like if you, whether now or after some time to heal and reflect, if you look at where you wanted to go, what you truly wanted out of a relationship, how you wanted to grow and evolve together, that person would not have been able to meet your needs. That person wouldn't have been on your level, I'm feeling like, because I feel like you're in this process of healing and ascension. And you know, as cheesy as it is, spirit's redirection is protection, right? But this is really spirit trying to help you out. So in terms of, like I said, you know, movement, communication, this would be a no. But in terms of stability, healing, especially healing, things improving, I do feel like this is a tentative yes. But this is mostly, sorry, I had a burp stuck. This is mostly a time to really work on self-healing. So I hope this has been helpful. I'm wishing you guys the best, brightest, most beautiful things that life has to offer. Thank you, Group One, so much for being here. And I am going to move on to Group Two. Ah, shit. Okie dokie. Hello, Group Two. So you guys picked the Bloodstone. This is a great grounding stone. This is also good for those of you who are asking questions about finances, business, starting a new business. And you can't really see it, but there's like, in this side, there's a little dip right here. So maybe you're kind of in this like valley, right? Where it's like, oh, you know, my finances were getting better and now I've kind of, you know, I lost a little bit of money, or I just, things have been kind of plateauing. And this is saying, like, this is okay. Ups and downs are normal. Grounding yourself in what is most important in your vision is really going to help here. Or just in general, there may be something where there was some instability and I feel like this is restabilizing for you. So this is a playing card deck I use for my yes or no answers. This is, I utilize cardomancy, where I'm using the 52 cards of a standard playing card deck to, and their equivalencies to the minor arcana in order to get our yes or no. So we have, ooh, okay, we have the Three of Swords. We have Tennessee referenced here. We also have the number 6 and 3. This is a no. Interesting. But you know what? I feel like this is almost like a happy no for a lot of you. And I'm getting dynamic. Things are moving forward. It's like there's a current here, right? There's a flow. Things are like, this feels like a positive no, even if you don't know where it's going yet. I feel like this is something with that Three of Swords energy you've been worrying about. It's been on your mind a lot. And so like, if this is a question of like, you know, let's say you own a business and you're like, it's been slow lately. Is my dream dead in the water? Nope, it's on track. Just go with the flow. Like it's going in the right direction. But yeah, let's see what else you get, because this is interesting. Oh, you have merriment. I love that. And you've got Between Worlds. Yeah, exactly. Another three going on here. So I'm going to get to this. This is your advice card. I'm going to get to this in a moment. I feel like whatever the situation is, again, because I know you can't see super well, so I apologize. On the stone, we have that little dip in the middle, and then it's the same, like, it's, you know, rising on either side. This, to me, says that you're kind of, like, in this middle, like, this little valley, and I feel like you're about to go with the crown and then the stepping into the color. I feel like you're about to go into this massive upgrade, like, expansive mindset, very dynamic. Things are going to be, if you'll pardon me, fucking great. And I'm really, really stoked for you. But right now, I feel like you're in this, you know what they're kind of showing me is if the flamingo had walked in backwards, right? I feel like your head is still in the black and white zone and you're like backing in. It's like, it's going to be a surprise for you. I feel like, whatever this is, I feel like you don't, like you see it coming, but there's like a part of it that's still a total surprise for you. And with merriment, I do feel like the final outcome of this situation is going to make you really, really happy. For some of you, again, this was a very positive no, where you're like, oh, fuck yeah, woohoo. Because with the Three of Swords, some of you may have been fearing a yes because it would have like been heartbreaking for you. And this is being like, nah, especially if this is a relationship because we have two people. And it's like, nah, boo, like, this is fine, you're fine. So if you'd asked a question like, are they cheating? This is like, nope. This feels like a very positive no. And even if you're experiencing it as a negative no, I feel like it's just saying like, no, wait, we have something even better. Like, you're going to love it. You're going to be surprised. It's going to be like going from black and white into color. It's going to be so much better than you ever expected. I think time with friends right now, time spent with loved ones, time having fun and engaging in celebration is really important at this time. Because again, we also have the number 6, and that's the number of unconditional love, balance, harmony. So trying to find balance, trying to find peace, you know, restorative connections, rejuvenation, excuse me. All of that is really going to ease this transition. But you're right on track. Things are moving along. Like, things are going forward, even if you kind of feel like you're in the valley right now. So this is your advice card. You have, oh, heart chakra. Love is at the heart of the matter. Your heart is the center within your physical being, attuned most to love. It's safe for you to love and be loved with an open heart as we stand by with perfect protection and guidance. Yeah. So this is why I feel like we have the stairs there as well. There's some ascension. And I feel like there, again, you're in that valley. So it's like, it's this energy, and this might be with a love relationship where it's like, is it over? Are they cheating? You know, something pretty much like, is it as bad as it looks? And this is like, nope, not the case. And again, if this was something where you were hoping for a yes, I feel like what your guides are trying to tell you is that we love you. We love the shit out of you. And we are bringing you into everything you've ever wanted and some extra sprinkled on top. Right? It's like, it's safe for you to love. It's safe for you to trust that what you want is coming into your reality. Because like your guides are really looking out for you. They love you a lot and you've earned this, right? Wear your crown, know what you deserve and know that it's coming toward you. And it's a celebration with all the confetti here. Like there's a celebration of your growth, of your excellence. And there's a little hummingbird here on the card as well, in case that's important for anybody here. things are moving faster than you would think. This one was pretty short, sweet, to the point. I think this is everything I have for my lovely group twos. I hope this has been helpful. If you're looking for help with your specific situation, please feel free to check out my shop. But other than that, it's been an honor, a joy, and a delight to get to have you here with me today. Thank you so much for your time. So many blessings to you, and I'm gonna move on to group three. Bye, guys. Okay, hello, group three, my sweet little peacock aura babies. It's her do it, let it shine, boo, let it happen, let it fly, let it really just let it do whatever. There's something where it's just like, go for it. I don't know, show off your like your true colors, right? You know, let your flag fly. There we go. So this is a playing card from a playing card deck that I use for yes or no's, right? I use cardomancy, where you use playing card decks, and they have equivalencies to the 52 cards of the minor arcana in order to get our yes or no. If you've ever gotten a yes or no reading with me, you've seen these bad boys before. So thank you to you if you have, or for anyone who's ever booked with me. I love you guys. So to answer your question, your yes or no question, we have the Eight of Cups. So we have eight reference here as well as four and two. We have North Dakota reference and the letters N and D. This is a no. And as opposed to like group three, I felt like it was a very positive no. I'm kind of feeling like there's some sadness here. I feel like for a lot of you, so it's really interesting because this stone is associated, if I remember correctly, with a sign of Cancer. I feel like whatever this is, many of you already saw this coming. I feel like with the Eight of Cups, you've known for a while that this situation needs to evolve or you need to let it go. You know, you need to walk away from it because it's something, you know, the Eight of Cups is always about staying in a situation or having been in a situation where, you know, there's emotional attachment. You have history, you have a lot of love for whatever it is, whoever it is, but you're not growing anymore. They're not meeting your needs. You're not expanding, you're just stagnating, and it kind of just the energy starts to wither on the vine, if you will. So this is a no. I do feel like this is generally not a very super positive no. We have a four, which is a number of stability, and a two, which we talk about balance and partnerships. So there's a question of like, will we ever come back together? Will we ever have a stable union? Are we going to work this out? I do feel like the answer is no. And I'm sorry to say that. But this is in order for you to go find your truest sense of happiness, because what always follows is the nine and ten of cups, right? That's a personal wish come true. And then that's like the happy relationships, home, family, things like that, total emotional fulfillment. This is very much a blessing in disguise kind of energy. So let's see what we got. Okay, we have Malady. And this is advice I'll save for at the end. And we have Go the Distance. This is card 47 that reduces to an 11/2. So again, more relationship energy. and we have this cheetah. And you know the thing that's interesting with this cheetah is that it looks like it's disintegrating, right? It's like going so fast. So whatever this is, maybe this is something where there's a lot of passion. It's like the lights that burn brightest are the ones that burn shortest. But this is something where I feel like there was stamina, there was power, but it's like it's fading away. Whatever this is feels like it's fading. Maybe this is something where, you know, it kind of has this energy because we have the flag here, right? Where it's like you've gone really far together and you've progressed really far together. And then it's just now it's kind of falling apart. It's running out of steam now. With Malady coming through, this could be something that's really what I'm getting is like draining your energy. Some of you could be dealing with health problems. And I, you know, I'm not a professional mental or physical health professional. So nothing we're talking about should be considered like substitution for professional diagnosis, treatment, or advice. But this kind of feels like something where it's like, you know, whatever this is, the biggest thing I'm getting is this is like draining your energy. This has been a weight on you. I want to get what your advice is. Entrepreneur, interesting. So it says self-employment suits your disposition, and intentions. Working for yourself allows you to better follow your intuition and divine guidance. We are your co-workers and teammates who remain loyally by your side to ensure your success in all ways. Yeah, there's something here where it's like, I feel like the environment you've been in, maybe this is about a job where you're thinking about leaving. For some of you, I will say, you know, you might have your own business and with all the mountains in the background, it's been a struggle, right? And you're feeling tired, you're feeling drained. And it's like, I don't know if I can keep going with this. And if the question was, do I give up on this? The answer is actually no, right? I do feel like some adjustments would need to be made, particularly with the peacock or in like bringing more of your authentic self into what you do. So maybe your business needs like a little bit of a change up, needs a facelift. It needs more of your authentic self in it, in some way, shape or form. But you'd be surprised at making, so like maybe if you're doing something creative with all the orange, it's like you're, you know, doing something that like structuring your content the way a lot of other people would do it. And it's like, no, you've got to do it your way. You have to be totally you. Cause there's something where you're in this situation, you're following one set of rules. You're doing things one particular way because you feel like you should, or you have history, there's investment there. But it drains you, right? It doesn't sustain you. And with all the fire here, this is like the Ace of Wands. Your team is really saying like, we're coming along to give you that extra push, that inspiration, so you can go the distance with it. If this is a work situation where you're thinking about leaving for a new job, a new career, starting your own business, you know, if you're asking like, should I stay at this job? If it's draining you and it's not something you actually love, no. It's better to, what I'm hearing is it's better to bet on yourself. And now is the time, more so than ever. We have magenta here. This is the color of universal love. You have something to say because she's wearing magenta as well. You have something to say. You have a message of love to spread. You have an energy that people would benefit from experiencing. Your team is backing you up 110%. I haven't done this for the other groups. I kind of want to pull an extra card just to kind of get a little bit of insight, not as a yes or no, but just a little bit of insight here, just because it doesn't quite feel done. Wow, okay, three flipped over. Yeah, exactly. Two of Swords, King of Wands, and Ten of Wands. So this most likely is a creative project or involving a masculine fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This could be you, could be someone else. If this is business or creative related, this is you really standing in your creative power and like letting go of the baggage, letting go of the burdens of what you don't need, of what's draining your energy because it's keeping you in a stalemate. And if this has to do with a person, this is saying you have carried the burden of this relationship because you love this person, because you care about them, because there is, you know, there has been a lot of movement and energy here. But holding on to, because this to me is also a very self-possessed energy, holding on to this relationship is keeping you stuck in other areas of your life and causing instability with, again, the two and the four, causing instability. So maybe focusing on other areas of your life, like your career or your creative projects, is going to be a really good way to help transition you out of this situation emotionally and energetically. So I think that's just about everything I have for you, group three. I hope this has been helpful. If you need help with your specific situation, please feel free to check out my shop link in the description box below. Other than that, I'm wishing you guys the best, brightest, most beautiful things that life has to offer. Take care. Hi, group four. Okie dokie. So you have this beautiful green calcite. This always makes me think of the ocean. I just love it. I'm hearing speak up, speak from the heart. Express yourself. What have you got to lose? There's nothing to lose. So, This is from a playing card deck that I always use for my yes or no's, utilizing cardomancy when you take playing card decks. And you, the 52 cards have equivalency to the 52 of the minor arcana. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Yeah. So let's see what you have. This is how we draw out our yes or no. Okay, so you have the Five of Pentacles. We have Louisiana reference here. We also have LA, so Los Angeles could also be important. We have a five and a seven reference. So any of those numbers, letters, initials, etc., locations could be important. So this is a no, but I'm trying to figure out if I feel, because there's one grouper is a no and it felt very negative. One grouper is a no, it felt really positive. The Five of Pentacles is really feeling like you don't have enough. This is feeling left out in the cold, left out by spirit. And this is usually either in the connections in your life or usually it's like monetarily. But because we have the green calcite, there's something where I feel like there's this fear of speaking up. I feel like you're in a holding pattern. Like maybe you're in a relationship where it's kind of good, but it's not really meeting all your needs. Or you guys are like friends right now, but you want to be more. Maybe this is a family relationship where you're like, you have a lot of love there, but you really want there to be a change in the dynamic. There's something where it's you have a lot of like you stick together in this situation, but you want something to be different, but you're afraid to speak up and rock the boat lest you lose them altogether or like cause a lot of ups and downs. And I actually feel like it'll be a lot more of a positive thing than you're intending, like than you think it will be if you speak up. Sorry, I'm just looking at this. I also feel for some of you, there's a work situation where you have an idea of what you have an idea to make a change and you want to express it, but there's fear of like rocking the boat again is the big thing I'm picking up here, where you're like, oh, I want to, ask for this promotion. I want to like lead this team. I thought of this change we could make, but I don't want to, it's essentially this energy of like, I don't want to lose what I already have because you might be kind of struggling a little bit as it is. But that's kind of what I'm picking up is there's this fear of loss, this fear of not having enough. If you speak up and speak your mind, speak what's on your heart. And I feel like that's not going to be the case, right? Like it might not be that you get what you want, but it will help alleviate the energy. So let's see what you get. Okay, yeah, you have hope. Okay, I like that. So, all right, chop wood. This is a 42, so that reduces to a six. And this is your advice card that I'm going to read in a minute. Yeah, whatever this is, you work really hard in this situation, right? The doors are wide open. Excuse me. And we have a broom here. And so I feel like there is this potential. You see this potential. There's a gateway, there's a portal here, right? And there's an opportunity to clean something up. And I like that she's even gesturing toward the card. There's an opportunity to clean something up because I feel like you and someone else, or you and part of the situation, like you're on the hook for each other. So you might kind of feel like you're more invested than they are, or like you have more to lose. That's not the case. If this is a job situation, you might be like, I don't want to say anything lest I lose ground or, rock the boat and this is a bad thing. And I like how we were saying that, and there's a boat in the back. But there's like, I don't think you understand how much power you wield, right? This is like, and it's interesting, we're talking about the ocean. We have the water here too. I don't think you understand how much power you wield, right? Like, if this is a work situation, they need you on the team more than you realize. This is a lot more of an even negotiation than you might be aware of, because I feel like you're afraid to speak your truth, because there's like, I don't want to ask for too much, but they're saying, nope, you hold more power here than you realize. There's also two roses. So there's, especially if you say it with love, you're able to express your truth honestly and authentically, but compassionately, kindly, and being considerate of all other factors or people involved. I feel like there is gonna be like this balanced, again, you're both like on the hook, or you and this company, you and this team, whatever it is, you're both equally hooked and invested. And it's going to turn out better than you think. You're both going to be happy with the way things end up or pan out. You'll be satisfied with it. It's like, okay, because what always follows the Five of Pentacles is the Six of Pentacles, and that's reciprocity, balance, generosity. And so especially, this is a card of hard work, of putting in the hours. Whoever you are talking to, they're going to see how much effort you really put in, how much love you've poured into, this relationship, this project, this job. And it's like, okay, you know what? I've seen how hard you're willing to work on this. If you ask me for this, you're putting it out there, you're throwing this out here with with love and compassion, or, you know, with kindness and respect, I'm going to try to meet you partway, because they recognize your value in this situation. If this is something where you've had some, you know, fights or some turbulence with somebody you care about, they want to clean it up with you. They really see your value, and they want to make sure they're demonstrating that. So if you come to them and say, hey, you know, I'd like to see this change, they're going to be a lot more receptive to that, I feel, than you realize. So let's see your advice. Sorry, I had a total brain fart. Okay, you have life purpose. The purpose of your life is to serve in a way that brings great joy to yourself and others. Don't worry about finding your purpose. Instead, focus on serving a purpose, and then your purpose will serve you. This is kind of what I feel like is this is talking about. And look, we have an open doorway. Excuse my burp. I feel like this is something where you've shown up, you've been really, you know, with a heart here, you've been loving, you've been thoughtful, generous with your time, energy, effort, labor, with your emotions. And by expressing yourself authentically, but in like from the heart, but also holding your ground, I feel like you're opening a door, right? Whoever this is on the other side of this is going to be like, you know, this is also why I'm thinking work, because it almost looks like we have one adult and then we have the little angels. It's like there's a boss and then there's a whole team, right? And it equals up to five. So, and this also something too right here in this card where it's like you put in your time, right? So whatever you've put in the time and the effort, and this is a very positive karmic, karmic return for you. So whatever you're asking for is very reasonable, and especially the more calmly and compassionately, but firmly you're able to ask for it, the better the results will be. This person's been kind of keeping track. It's like a little ledger, not like writing it down, but like keeping track of what you've done, right? Especially if you ask them to review it. If you ask for like, you know, I want to take this next step in this relationship, I want this responsibility, they're going to kind of think back and be like, you know what? I don't want to lose group four. I don't want to jeopardize this. Yeah, they've really earned it. So I don't know if you'll get everything you want, but I think it will be a lot more positive than you realize. So this is technically a no, but I feel like this is a very positive no. This is a no that could change into a yes when you express your thoughts, feelings, needs, and desires. So I do feel like ultimately this is a very positive thing. Fairness and balance are the thing here. So this is about everything that I have for you. I hope this has been helpful. I'm wishing you the best, brightest, most beautiful things that life has to offer. And with that, I'm going to move on to group five. Bye, guys. Ooh, there we go. Okay, hello group five. I'm kind of settling in here. So you have this little amethyst. Normally I don't think this, but this kind of feels like something where it's like, I feel like you don't have all the answers yet. So I feel like this is like, there are still moving pieces. There are things that haven't even been shown to you yet. So whatever I'm getting really strongly, whatever comes out here is just a piece of the puzzle. Keep following your intuition and then you will gain clarity over time. But this is something where you're not going to get all the pieces right away. This reading might not answer all your questions, but they're giving you what information you can have at this stage in your journey. So this is from a playing card deck that I use for my yes or no's. Cardomancy is where you use a traditional playing card deck and then use its equivalencies to the minor arcana to gain insight and information. And so I always do this to draw out a yes or no. So let's see what your answer is. Oh boy. Wow. We have had so many no's in this reading. Interesting. So you have the five of spades, which is the five of swords, and it's got the U.S. territories on it. We have the names Marshall and Mariana on this card. So those might be people's names. Sorry, we also have the Virgin Islands, and I'm like, so you might be a virgin. I don't know why that came to mind. So I want to mention too, I feel like even though this is a no, so this is usually a card about petty people, people who just kind of like say whatever they need to say in the heat of the moment to win the argument. They don't care how they hurt your feelings. They just want to win in that moment. They're so blinded by their own ego in that moment that they can't think past it, right? And they might regret it later on when they realize like they're not thinking about the damage it does to the relationship or to the situation. If this is a boss, this is somebody who can be like just demanding and, you know, insulting. Whoever this person's a pain in the dick. Or, you know, these people involved. This situation involves a lot of triggering. I feel like it involves a lot of, like, aggressive or passive aggressive communication. It's just inflammatory all over the place. I can't stand this card. So whatever this is a no, but I feel like this is like saving your ass kind of a no. Like your team wants you to know this if you're not already suspecting this. Like whoever's involved in this situation, it could be multiple people with the five, they are just not mature. They are emotionally triggered all the time and they make it everybody else's fault but theirs. And that's not a pattern I feel they're ready to grow out of anytime soon. The Five of Swords can also talk about internal mental chaos and conflict, where you're both always the victor and the loser within yourself, where it's like, you know, that kind of feeling of like, I think I'm going to go hurt my own feelings today. It's kind of that energy. So whatever the situation is, it keeps you in doubt. It keeps you stressed out. It just keeps you in a kind of a shitty headspace. So the answer is a no automatically, because you need to be alleviated of this situation, whether you're aware of this yet or not. Especially if you know, for all my empaths, highly sensitives, clairsentience out there, you might be really picking up this energy without realizing it. And you're kind of like, gee, especially if this is like multiple people you're surrounded by, like family members, you know, coworkers, it's like, gee, why is it that I feel like shit all the time? This is because of this. So there might be a situation where, like, you know, if you're like, oh, well, I, you know, get approved for this living arrangement with these people, or, you know, will I be moving to this department at work? The answer is no. And I feel that the answer is to protect you from whatever this is. There is shit about this you don't know. You might find this out much later over time, where it's like you really dodged a bullet, right? If this is like wanting stuff to work out in a relationship, this is like no, because there might be friends, family, third party, like, you know, other lovers involved, and it's just a fucking shit show. Like, I'm hearing really clearly, you don't deserve that bullshit. There is more at play here than you're aware of. And they're coming in strong with that. So let's see what you have. Oh shit, you have death. Okay. We have a little hourglass right here. Again, in time, you will find out about this in greater detail. I like how the skeleton's just like, so what? I'm dead. Like, doesn't matter. I'm dead now. I don't know why that's so funny to me. You have, okay, flexible. This is 19, so that reduces to a 10/1. And this is your advice card. I'm gonna save it. Yeah, excuse me. This almost, you know what? There's a card in the tarot. It's a 7 of cups. And somebody's trying to decide between 7 cups in front of them. They all have different shit in it. And they're kind of like, holy shit, there's so much to choose from. What's good? What's bad? What should I do? What not? There's one cup, where it has a laurel wreath in it. And if you look super closely, it's got a skull on it, right? And so this to me is always one that looks like the road to success, but that actually either leads to a dead end or a very hefty like transformation. So, you know, in more of its light elements, it's like, you know, this changes you as a person, but I think of it more like it looks like victory in a cup, but it's actually like dead end. Like it's not going anywhere. You know what's also kind of weird? I like that it's a skeleton, but it's still wearing a robe. Like, I feel like whatever this is, there's something of like somebody pretending to be something they're not, or like holding on to something they don't need anymore is actually more the energy I'm getting. Because this person is naked as all get out. It's just their skin. I feel like whatever this situation is, so you're a flexible person, right? Especially with the egg imagery, I think you see the potential in things. You want to let things grow. You know, you're willing to, you know, even at times you might be one of those people that's like, you'll bend over backward to make it work. This is why I'm saying, like, you know, empaths, clairsentients, highly sensitives, who might have a hard time understanding where they end and other people begin. I feel like this is something where you might kind of be working on learning how to identify that better, or like how to be more boundaried, and that's amazing. But there's something about this group of people or the people involved, they're like, they would next level energetically fuck your shit up, if you don't mind me saying. I feel like these are people who would have you bending over backwards for them, and they wouldn't think twice about it, right? There'd be something where I feel like there's something here where you don't need to deal with it. And I feel like there's this, you know, the death energy is always about transformation and rebirths and big endings and beginnings. So I feel like there's something here where it's like maybe you've ended one cycle and you feel like you're ready to begin this new one. Because again, the body language here is kind of like, what? It feels like you don't really understand what's going on. It's kind of like you're in this in-between, or you think you're, you know, this, because they're looking at this card. It's like, it feels like you're looking at this card as your new beginning and you're like, what the hell? Why didn't I, you know, get approved for this? Why didn't I get invited for this? Why did this person break up with me? You know, why this, why that? Or, you know, like, you know, you could be somebody who you're sort of going through this transformation and then people in your life are kind of starting to rebel against that. It's like, what the hell? Because these people are not of a similar vibration and frequency. Whatever's falling away, disintegrating from your life is a huge blessing, because this is some bullshit, babe. And you don't deserve to deal with that. And I feel like the higher your frequency is too, the more that energy could like can permeate your auric field and kind of like, it's like stacking damage. like it really takes its toll over time. Something about this feels like it's creeping in. It's very insidious. It's not a good energy. So whatever this is a no to. There's more about this that you're not aware of, and it is an absolute damn blessing. So let's see what you have. You have daydream. You will more easily hear and receive our messages if you daydream regularly. Relax and open your mind to receiving without directing your thoughts. Just notice any feelings, visions, or ideas as if you were watching a movie. This is the seat of creativity. So something I'm kind of getting here is a couple different things. One, this is a very Neptunian energy to me. Again, very Seven of Cups. I feel like there's something where it looks like a really good opportunity to you, and it's like, you might not have all the information, or you might not be seeing it clearly right now. There's something where it's elusive to you. And it's kind of like, I don't know, kind of has this energy of like, you know, I'm bending over backwards to make this work. Why isn't it happening? This is because you're being protected. But this is also saying, you know, if this didn't really work, now is the time to kind of think about what you do want instead. And also too, to the biggest thing I'm getting is to make sure you still are manifesting, make sure you're focusing on what you want, your dreams, what you want them to feel like. And any creative projects you have are a really good outlet to kind of get that energy out. Cause I feel like there's something here about energy purging and clearance that's really, really important. So if you have any energy clearance rituals you do, this would be a great time to do them. But overall, your answer is a no. It's a blessing for you. It is seriously saving your ass, I promise. And I'm just wishing you guys the best and brightest, most beautiful things that life has to offer. I hope the situation looks up for you. And I'm thinking of you fondly today, my sweet love bugs. So that's just about everything that I have for you guys. I hope this has been helpful. I'm wishing you the best and brightest, and I will be seeing you soon. Bye, guys.